The last 2 weeks, at least 100 cases of the novel coronavirus infections have been reported almost on a daily basis. 137 new COVID-19 cases were reported today, bringing the total of those infected in the country to 3,594 persons. But as the numbers of those infected increase, so does the number of those who have recovered, as 32 people were discharged today. Unfortunately, three more people died, raising the total number of those who have succumbed to COVID-19 to 103. Out of 11 counties affected, Nairobi bore the biggest burden with 92 cases, Mombasa County with only 16, Kajiado with 14, while Busia and Kiambu counties recording 4 cases each. The other 4 counties, including Kilifi, Nakuru, Nyamira, Uasin Gishu, Siaya and Murang'a, recorded a case each.
Wakujikinga mwenyewe, because the government is not going to prevent COVID-19. It is the individuals who are going to make sure that we do not get this disease. And I have said, assume the person next to you is COVID-19 positive. Kwanza ukimwona hana mask, go away. You know? Just move away from that person.
The case in Nyamira, according to Governor John Nyagarama, was an individual who traveled from Nairobi for a funeral, with residents raising the alarm, prompting the county's emergency team to pick the individual and quarantine them. 14 contacts were traced and are in mandatory quarantine at Nyamira KMTC. The rising number of COVID-19 infections have stretched and tested Kenya's health system, revealing a silent threat to the fight against COVID-19, the burden of non-communicable diseases, such as diabetes and cancer. Such diseases account for at least 27% of the total deaths and over 50% of total hospital admissions in Kenya.
Persons living with NCDs are more at risk of becoming severely ill with coronavirus disease than those without. To protect persons living with NCDs from the effects of COVID-19, my ministry has been running an awareness campaign and issued guidelines to health on the management of patients with COVID-19 and NCDs, as well as guidelines for continuity of NCD and mental health services in our health facilities.
However, it is the guidelines set by the government as measures to contain the virus that have been the subject of debate in the country. It was on Friday when Luo musician Abeni Jachiga, who according to his family succumbed to pneumonia, was buried at 2:30 a.m., allowing only his brother to witness his burial. A situation that goes far away from the COVID-19 guidelines that allow 15 family members to attend their relative's funeral. And a trend of double standards, as seen in the burial of John Nzenze, a legendary Kenyan twist musician.
Therefore, what we need to put in place is to be cognizant of our cultural practices. If the culture dictates that we don't bury at night, please just hold on for another 12 hours so that we're able to bury the following day.
Additionally, a similar scenario was also experienced in the cases of politicians holding public gatherings in the country. A gathering conducted by Boni Khalwale was on Sunday disrupted by police officers after tear gas was lobbed into the crowd. Quite different from how a gathering conducted by Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa and other leaders to discuss Luhya unity ahead of 2022 elections was handled. Quite different from how a gathering conducted by Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa and other leaders to discuss Luhya unity ahead of 2022 elections was handled, with the set measures proving to seemingly favor some over others.
I want also to say that there are no two laws in Kenya. The laws apply to everybody equally. Yes. And we are the ones who should be setting the example of how to do that. Yet, there is leadership that is setting an example of how to break the law.
With the set measures proving to seemingly favor some over others, the COVID-19 pandemic continues to alter the lives of many. Rachel Migai, Citizen TV.